put together for you guys 3 healthy breakfast ideas, and as a bonus, they're all really delicious. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first breakfast idea are egg muffins, and eggs are always a must in your breakfast because they have so much protein in them and they'll fill you up throughout the day. The first thing you're gonna need are some veggies of your choice, and over here I have some cherry tomatoes, and personally I think cherry tomatoes taste way better than normal tomatoes. So all you have to do is chop up your veggies in little pieces. Next, I just diced up some red peppers. As an extra kick of protein, I put in some pepperoni, and you can put any type of meat that you'd like, sausages or bacon, whatever you prefer. And as my choice of green veggies, I just chopped up some spinach. After you've cut up all your ingredients, you're just gonna want to mix all of them in a bowl. After that, I preheated my oven to 180 degrees Celsius, and as a topping for my muffins, I decided to grate some cheese, and you can pick any type of cheese that you'd like, or you can mix 2 types of cheese like I did. Now moving on to the main ingredient of the recipe, the eggs. So I cracked 7 eggs, but that's because I did 12 muffins. If you want less, obviously you can crack less. And then I just whisked this up until it was kind of foamy. The more you mix it, the more it rises in the oven. And here's when you can put in your baking powder to have some really fluffy muffins. And now get all your ingredients and your muffin tin and put a little bit of oil into your muffin tin so that muffins don't stick to the pan. Don't believe me, just watch. After lightly greasing your pan, you can start putting your veggies as the base. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. And now you can carefully pour in your egg juice? What do you call mixed up eggs? I don't know. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. I said uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up. Don't forget to add in salt and pepper for some extra taste. Flown it. If you freak dead and own it. Don't beg about it, come show me. And now you can put in your cheese right on top of the muffins. And I felt like a chef doing this. I don't know, it was just really fun for me. Once you're done, you can pop them right into the oven. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. All you gotta do is set your timer to 15 minutes and just wait. Once your timer goes off, carefully remove your muffins, and they don't look that cute, but I promise you, they taste amazing. I always eat 2, okay, maybe 3. And sometimes 4 before I go to school, and they taste superb and they're always filling. Moving on to my favorite recipe out of the 3, and when I make this, I always feel like Manhattan's elite. It is this coconut French toast. So to make this, you're gonna need some whole grain bread, 2 eggs, and crack them right into your bowl. Mix them up, it's that easy. Then they can walk on by. My feet can touch the ground, and I can't hear a sound, but you just keep on running up your mouth, yeah. And then I like to add some coconut milk and this just gives the most perfect taste ever. And you can just shake up that coconut milk and pour in however much you'd like, because it really doesn't matter. It depends on how much coconut taste you want to get. And again, mix it all up. And then add in some cinnamon, because what even is French toast without a bit of cinnamon? After greasing up my pan and turning on my stove, obviously, I dipped in my bread right into that mixture that we did earlier, and then I got it and put it on the pan and started frying it. After around a minute, I flipped it to the other side, and it just has to look like this, a little golden brown, and I just kept on making more because I couldn't stop. They just tasted and looked like perfection. And as a side for the toast, I cut up some fresh strawberries and also bananas. Any fruits that you'd like will do, guys. Words don't mean a thing, I'm not listening. Keep talking, all I know is mama told me not to waste my life. No! And now all I gotta do is make it look as if it belongs on We Heart It. So I sprinkled on a little bit of cinnamon and a little bit of coconut flakes, and the coconut flakes make it taste amazing. Trust me, guys, it tastes just as good as it looks. The next recipe is this cheese and spinach quesadilla. Quesadilla, am I saying that right? Anyways, it's the easiest out of the three, so let's get started. The hardest step out of all of the steps is probably cutting up your parsley. So, I mean, guys, how hard can this recipe possibly get? Don't forget to grease your pan, and then I just got my spinach tortilla and put it on the pan, preferably whole grain if you want it to be extra healthy. And then I just had some parsley and some cheese. So I got my cheese and sprinkled it on there. Again, the whole chef movement, I love it. And then on top of that, I put on my parsley. And then on top of that, I put on my cheese. Again, we're doing the whole layering thing, you know, super simple. Afterwards, put on a top layer of tortilla and then flip it over. I forgot to film myself flipping it over. I mean, it just cut off. But anyway, all you gotta do is put it on a plate, and then I got my pizza cutter and cut it up with that to make it look like a pizza. And the cheese was all melted inside, and it was just pure perfection. And I actually shared it with my mom, and she really liked it. And if she likes it, then it was good, guys. Cheers. I said, can you give it back to me? She said, never knew I was James. And we danced. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you like my recipes, and if you try them out, tweet me a picture. And I love you all, so Pluto, I'm back. Bye!
Give me some!